Now, I promised you that Kathy would be in the studio from the Waimak District Council, and she is. Hi, Kathy. How are you this morning?
I'm great, thank you. A little bit cold.
Kathy Graham, she is the Road Safety Coordinator at the Waimak District Council. And, you know, in June we've had some of our coldest winter temperatures, and drivers are getting caught out with the icy conditions. There's been quite a bit of a spate of crashes recently around the Waimak District and the Huranui as well, and it's partly due to drivers just failing to adapt to the conditions. So tell us a bit about the problems that we're seeing on the roads at the moment.
So I think just looking back over the last couple of years, this winter has been a lot colder than we've had over the last couple of years. So people have probably forgotten what it's like to have black ice on our roads. So I guess just people not being prepared for the icy conditions. We've seen a few runoff road crashes where people just hit the ice and unfortunately don't take the right action, which is don't brake when you hit ice, because that's going to, you just don't have any traction.
I guess you panic, don't you?
You do. That's instinct and that's natural. So I guess the key message there is that we really want people to reduce their speed. If we have these conditions forecast that it's going to be low temperatures overnight, just expect that the roads are going to be slippery. If you can delay your travel, that's one of the biggest things. We've encouraged our own staff to, if they don't have to be there right at 8 o'clock, that it is a health and safety matter. Don't feel pressured to drive when you're not safe or when you don't feel comfortable. So bridges are worse for ice. They seem to apparently ice up quicker. Any areas that are shaded, and we have a number in our district, big long straight roads with lovely big shelter belts for the animals, but it does create shading on our roads, so they can be particularly icy. Anywhere where the sun doesn't get can have ice on it all day, so it's not necessarily just a morning thing, obviously, to be aware first thing in the morning, but be aware all day in these cold conditions.
Yeah, of course, because if it never gets sun, it's never going to melt, really.
No.
Okay. So there's also another funny kind of thing is sunstrike at the moment as well as the ice. You've got the sun.
You do, yes. Which we love. We love the sun, but of course, often with the cold conditions, your windows can fog up a bit, or certainly in the morning you have the ice on your windscreen, and you might be driving. Again, we have a lot of east to west roads, which is where our sun comes up and goes down. So if you're travelling that way, you're going to get it morning and night. Again, key thing there is reduced speed, because your visibility sometimes is impaired. And also just make sure your windscreens are clean. That can't reinforce that enough, and I know I'm a little bit lax in doing that, both clean inside and out. And I guess the other thing is, one of the things we see both with the low sun but also with fog conditions is put your lights on. We can see, you know, when you're driving, you can see where you're going. My big thing is I want other drivers to see me. So if someone's looking into the sun, they get a glare, they may not even see your vehicle, particularly in fog. People just can't see you. So I guess, as I say, you can see where you're going, and people think they don't need their lights on, but I want other people to be able to see me coming. I don't want someone to pull out of an intersection in front of me because they haven't seen me, because I've faded into the background.
Kathy Graham is the Road Safety Coordinator at the Waimak District Council. And so, what Kathy, you're saying that in the winter we should really have our lights on all the time.
I like to have my lights on most of the time, yes. I think in the old road code, and look, to be honest, I don't know if it's still there, there were some rules about not having your lights on, certainly not your park lights, but if you notice, a lot of the European cars are actually built to have day running lights. Motorcycles modern motorcycles all have their lights on all day. It's just when you turn your bike on, your light comes on. It is a safety feature. And again, it comes back to helping other people see you, not for you to see where you want to go, but it's other people to see you.
Getting back to the ice, what about, I see, you know, the council have put grit on a lot of the areas. Does that help?
So grit does help, but it only reduces, it only helps by about 15%. So you only have about 40% of dry road friction left on the road. So having grit down, yes, it is a help, but grit itself can be slippery if you're travelling at speed, or if the grit, as you can appreciate, people tend to follow the track of the car in front of them, so the grit pushes to the side, that later in the day can become a hazard, and our contractors will go around and sweep that up and redistribute it for the next morning if needed.
Goodness.
But yes, don't assume if there's grit down that you can still travel at the same speed. It doesn't, it won't stop you sliding.
Okay, that's good to know. What else can we do to keep ourselves safe in this time?
So the biggest thing with any winter driving is reduce your speed. The speed limit's not a target. We don't have to travel at 100k on our open roads. If you feel that you're being pressured by someone behind you who wants to go 100, pull over, let them pass. I regularly drive 80 down tram road in these conditions because I don't feel safe. If for some reason something happens to me, if I end up running off the road, I want to be going at a slower speed so that the outcome is reduced for me. Don't assume people can see you. Again, sort of relating it to motorcycles, you tend to ride your bike like everyone's out to get you. I suggest people drive their car like that too, because people make mistakes on our roads. They don't intentionally run into you, but we know human nature, people make mistakes. So reducing your speed is a good way to reduce the outcome should something go wrong. Clean that windscreen.
Yeah.
Make sure you de-ice it. Don't just clean a little spot in front of your eyes where you can see. You want to be able to see your full vision. Check your vehicle's winter ready. Check your tyres, check your brakes. Make sure you understand what safety features your vehicle's got, like ABS, and how to use it. That's a real key. If you've driven an old car, you brake very differently in an old car without ABS than you do with an ABS vehicle. So just understanding those features is really key. We've got some ice scrapers and cloths available at our council service centres at the moment that people can come in and grab a couple, take those, use them. They're free to take, and we do encourage you to use them to clean those windscreens.
Those dinky little things. You know, my husband, he starts work in Rolleston every day at 7 a.m. and so
he needs one of those.
He's out there doing it, and you know, it's very easy to just think, oh, she'll be right in the morning when you're running a bit late for work or whatever. You know, and these are really cool. I haven't seen these before. So yeah, it's a nice scraper. You just and you can wipe the thing off as well.
You can, yeah.
Fantastic. So we've got 5 of these to give away. So if you would like to have one, absolutely give us a call on 311 7100. We've got 5 of these ice scrapers, or of course you can pop down to the service centres throughout the district and you can pick one up for free. Anything else that you can think of at the moment, Kathy, that would help us to stay safe around, well, especially schools and things, I guess, as well?
Yes, look, it is obviously with the rain and the wind and the icy conditions, the little ones are out there. They've got their raincoats on, they've got their hoods pulled down, they might have umbrellas. They are our most vulnerable road users, and I just can't reinforce enough, please do slow down around schools. Passing a school bus, it's 20k, that is the law, and that's for a reason. Little ones, you know, they see the bus coming, they're inclined to run for it, or they may get off it and run across, to get home. They don't think the way we think as adults. They don't perceive speed of vehicles as well as we do, so no one wants to hit a child. It's the worst outcome anyone could ever have. It takes, it won't impact your travel time. Slow down. That's all I can say. Yeah.
They're cold and they're miserable and they're just running and they're darting everywhere at the moment, and it's hard to see them. So do take care on the roads. And again, if you'd like one of these ice scrapers, make sure you give us a call now on 311 7100 for your free one. This is Kathy Graham from Roads. She's the Road Safety Coordinator at the Waimakariri District Council. Thank you for coming in to chat with us today.
Oh, thank you. It's I reinforce everyone is responsible for road safety. We all need to do our bit, keep each other safe.